good day to you. This is Todd. I am a regular dude walking in the Word. We are going through Numbers here, and we're in it today. It's entitled The Apprentice. God had called Moses to lead the people of Israel, and Moses leads them right up to the Promised Land. He's not allowing Moses to lead them into the Promised Land, but right up to the Promised Land. And we talked about yesterday how God had told Moses this, and Moses, if it would have been myself, I would have made a big stink, like, oh, it's not fair. How come I can't go into the Promised Land? And, you know, gave this whole 2-hour speech about that. But Moses does not do that. He doesn't concern himself all with that. He concerns himself with, Lord, please provide a people, a leader for these people here. And that was his prayer to that. We're going to read this whole thing here, this whole story here. Again, this is taken from Numbers chapter 27, verses 12 through 23. And it's entitled The Apprentice. Then the Lord said to Moses, go up to the mountains in the Arabim region and see the land I've given the Israelites. After you've seen it, you will too will be gathered to your people as your brother Aaron was. For when the community rebelled at the waters of the desert of Zin, both of you disobeyed my command to honor me wholly before their eyes. These were at the waters of Meribah Kadesh in the desert of Zin. Big thing here in verse 15 through 17 here, Moses' reply. Moses said to the Lord, may the Lord, the God who gives breath to all the living things, appoint someone over this community to go out and come in before them, who will lead them out and bring them in so the Lord's people will not be like sheep without a shepherd. Okay, we had spent quite a bit of time talking about that verse yesterday. Verse 18, so the Lord said to Moses, take Joshua, son of Nun, a man in whom is the spirit of leadership, and lay your hands on him. Have him stand before Eleazar the priest and the entire assembly and commission him in their presence. Okay, let me stop you there. Let me stop myself here. It says, take Joshua, son of Nun, a man in whom the spirit of leadership, and lay your hand on him. When did he ever have the spirit of leadership? You're thinking to yourself. Well, let me tell you when that was. When he was one of the 12 spies, and he came back with Caleb, and it was only Joshua and Caleb that stood up and said, there's giants here, and they're big people there, and it's going to be tough, but we believe God has given us this land, and we believe that God will take us into this land, okay? The other judges didn't say that thing. They were like, oh no, we're doomed, we're gonna die, and so forth. There's no way we can get in there. But it was Joshua and Caleb that stood up, and they were the only ones that stood up. And we have read in the previous chapters here, they were the only two guys that went into the Promised Land. Everyone else was, and Joshua and Caleb were the minority. They were the only two guys that stood up and said, we believe the Lord is leading us into the Promised Land. So that's where the spirit of leadership comes from. You know, they stand up for the Lord, and they're the minority here. Okay, so that's why God said that. Verse 19, have him stand before Eleazar the priest and the entire assembly and commission him in their presence. Give him some of the authority so that the whole Israelite community will obey him. He is to stand before Eleazar the priest, who will obtain decisions for him by inquiring of the Urim before the Lord. At his command in his entire community, the Israelites will go out, and at his command they will come in. Moses did as the Lord commanded him. He took Joshua and had him stand before Eleazar the priest, then the whole assembly. Then he laid his hands on them and commissioned him as the Lord instructed through Moses. Okay. The bottom line here is this. God had called Joshua, and Moses really made an apprentice of him for this time period, and gradually shifted the authority over to him. And God gave him authority, but it was this gradual transition. You don't want, at the end of your life, let's say you're in leadership of a ministry of some sort, you don't want to be doing nothing about your successor. And then when you die, it's like everyone's scrambling. Oh no, what are we going to do? There's no one to replace him. You should be, as you are in ministry, bringing up along someone that would take over your ministry. Ultimately, you want to work yourself out of a job. It's wrong for you to think, I'm the man that no one can replace me. You should be trying to have yourself replaced and be training up that person. And that's what Moses did here. He was called by God to lead the people, but not lead them into the promised land. And here he had Joshua, and he spent this time mentoring him, but Joshua was already a leader, okay? So that's another thing, too. You don't just pick anyone randomly, like, oh, Billy, yeah, you look like you might work, yeah. No, it's got to be called by God, and that's what happened. Joshua was called by God to be this apprentice, really. And so Moses worked with him. So look for that in your life. You might be a person that is the apprentice, okay? So look for a person that you can be following and the leader that would raise you up to be a leader in ministry. And you might be the leader in ministry, and you need to be looking for people to train up and work yourself out of a job, okay? Anyway, but that's it. Hey, thank you for watching. I am a regular dude walking in the Word, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow as we continue our journey through the book of Numbers. Lord's blessing. I'll see you then.